The interior monastery is a spiritual framework of life that needs no material place in the earthly world. I teach you how to live without a home in spirit. No faith has ever demanded the building of temples. They have arisen gradually as a manifestation of reverence. The first covenant has always been a spiritual and direct one. As physical basis for the sanctuary, it is sufficient to use a small devotional room, a family altar, or, if there is no space even for that, a prayer rug that is rolled up in a corner during the day. Within a small room, upon a small rug, you have shed your former scales. The wisdom thus released will receive a new skin. You will behave there as if your teacher were temporarily absent, as if he were working in the next room and could enter any moment. Let us imagine a dear one who is in an adjoining room absorbed in some important work. We are patient, knowing that we shall be together at the right time. You should have the same attitude toward us. This attitude will broaden your consciousness and is beneficial for your inner life. An ashram is everywhere where the holy atmosphere of spiritual discipline, contemplation, and selfless work prevails. The externals are meaningless. The inner temple is one of the many thought buildings that populate the subtle world. It is not a material, but a subtle reality. The ashram is a superstructure, a spiritual order of certain customs, laws, traditions, worldviews, and beliefs that vaults over your physical abode. In any place, you can proudly say, I am living in an ashram of the Brotherhood. But how do I erect this building? In the video Participation in the Life of the Higher World, we had already discussed in detail how you can first imagine an ideal, for example, an ashram, and then make it a living reality. If the clarity of the image of the teacher brings us into closest cooperation with him, then each clear and vivid conception of an object in our third eye makes it near and attainable. One of the conditions of ancient magic was to teach the vividness of objects evoked by our inner conception. If the object is called forth with all completeness of line and color, one can apply it to achieve the most immediate impact. One may, as it were, possess it. Without limitations of distance, one can direct it and use its possibilities. From the most customary objects to the far-off planets, one can utilize this influence. There is nothing of the supernatural in this. In a sense, one identifies with the duplicate and creates a vital connecting thread. One can gradually develop in oneself these abilities using habitual objects, noticing thereby that when a clear image is created, a peculiar trembling vibration occurs, similar to a magnetic influence. We now specify in relation to our today's topic, visualize the ashram on the holy mountain and yourself at the feet of your teacher. Imagine, dream, play that you are living in the community there. Project this image, this vision, into space and create a corresponding hologram, a subtle reality around you. No one admits that a thinker creates something real through his thinking. He builds structures in the subtle world. This is like an extension of your aura. You create the atmosphere of a sanctuary around you. Other people can sense this. In this way, your dream is densified more and more to become a material reality. I advise him who wishes to reach our community to add to his knowledge the dream to return to the mountain valley where it is possible to increase knowledge will constantly lead to the attainment of the goal. This is a spiritual exercise which can be carried out in any place. The monk of the inner temple is completely independent of local circumstances. You can establish your virtual monastery anywhere. A disciple of the Brotherhood does not care where and how he has to spend his incarnations in matter. He is continually living in the spiritual world of the inner sanctuary. In order to erect this subtle building, you must form a picture, an exact idea of your father's home. You will choose a place at a high altitude, preferably in a distant country in the Himalayas or in the Altai, where you are removed from earth and the burdens of everyday life, but closer to heaven, where from above you can observe life down in the valleys and you yourself in the middle of it. Erect your throne upon the highest summit. From there, you will better see the anxiety of human hearts. Picture your new dwelling as vividly as possible and imprint it firmly in your mind so that you can really live there in spirit. I can't build a place for my teacher, can I? I can only just conceive creating my own heaven with my thoughts and feelings. But how can I set up with my imagination the heaven of others, of my teacher and my fellow disciples? Who says that you alone have to create the home in this spiritual sphere in which your soul is to live?
You can build such a world in cooperation with others, or you can move into a dwelling others have erected, and later, together with your companions, embellish and extend it further and further. Make it absolutely clear to yourself, the place of your longing, your eternal home, is not far removed from you.
He who knows how to discern the presence of the higher world in the smallest things is already on the path of ascent. Indeed, it is needful in everything to link oneself to the higher world. Without such attachment, the path will be a long one. Amid the densest of earthly conditions, it is still possible to direct oneself toward the higher world, and this world of beauty will be close by.
It is not the external circumstances you have to change in order to get there, but only your consciousness.
We must be found not geographically, but first of all in spirit. The kingdom of God is taken by force, but in spirit.